The Teclast F5 is the 11.6-inch 2-in-1 convertible from China that costs around $300 US only. Even though it is so inexpensive, it features a full HD resolution and Intel Jamie Lake processor, 8GB of RAM and a 128GB SSD. How good can a convertible like this be? I'm NJ for MyNextTablet.com and this is my Teclast F5 review. The Teclast F5 is a convertible notebook. That means you can rotate the screen to convert the small notebook into a Windows tablet. I quite like the design of the Teclast F5. It looks nice, is pretty small and easy to carry. The bezels around the screen are very small and it is well built. It's just 30mm thin and weighs around 1kg. While we do get a metal back and bottom, the keyboard side is made of plastic. It's kind of soft plastic that feels kind of smooth. I can't think of the right word. It certainly does not feel like cheap plastic. On the right side and left side we get a speaker each. I've been surprised by the sound quality. Sure, we don't get a real bass at all, and tablets like the iPad Pro have much better speakers. However, for such a cheap device, the speakers are not bad and good enough to watch some YouTube. Most Chinese Android tablets I reviewed recently have worse speakers. The F5 features a microSD card slot, a microUSB port and a USB-C port on the right side. You can use the USB-C port to charge the device. It is a bit weird that we get a microUSB port and not just two USB-C ports, but well, at least Teclast ships it with a microUSB to USB 2.0 Type-A adapter. On the left side, we get a standard headphone jack, a power button and the volume controls. Like with a lot of Chinese notebooks, there is an SSD expansion slot on the back. Using that, you can replace the SSD easily and can insert one with a capacity of up to 512GB. I did not do that though. The keyboard is pretty good. Since the display is smaller, the keyboard is not as big as on a standard notebook. However, you can get used to that. The keys have a good pressure point, but the enter key is a bit small. Well, that's the only downside for me. Besides that, I think the keyboard is great. I've been able to type with it fast and precisely. Underneath the keyboard we get a precision touchpad. It works just as it should and supports all multitouch gestures built into Windows 10. Sadly, it is a bit small though. The position of the webcam is a bit unusual. Because of its smaller bezels, the camera is located underneath the screen. That way you can see your nose holes. However, the Teclast F5 is a convertible. So in tablet mode, you can just rotate it and the camera is on the top again. Well, the camera is not that good anyways. It has a resolution of 0.9 megapixels only, and photos and videos look not very sharp. They are a bit blurry, especially when the light is not good. The Teclast F5 has an 11.6-inch screen with an aspect ratio of 16:9. It is an IPS panel with a Full HD resolution of 1920x1080. For the screen size, I think the resolution is high enough. Text certainly looks sharp enough. Other aspects are pretty good too. Contrast and color reproduction are good. Oh, and it is a fully laminated screen. It's bright enough to use outside in the shadows too, but as you might expect, it is a bit too dark to use in direct sunlight. It is a touchscreen, so you can obviously navigate the notebook using your fingers. If you want, you can also get it with an active pen. I did not try that one though. Inside the Teclast F5 runs an Intel Celeron N4100 quad-core processor. That is the chipset of the new Gemini Lake generation. And those 4 cores are clocked at up to 2.4 GHz. In addition to that, we get 8GB of RAM and a 128GB SSD. The N4100 is a successor to the N3450 that we've seen in some Windows tablets last year. Its performance is pretty good for this price class, especially when combined with 8GB of RAM. In Geekbench 4, the Teclast F5 gets better results than devices with an Intel N4200 like the Acer Switch 3. It even scores better than the Microsoft Surface Go in the multicore test. The graphics performance is pretty good for the price too. In the Cinebench OpenGL benchmark, it scores better than the Lenovo IdeaPad D330. However, devices with a Core M3 are much better. In real life, the performance is as good as the benchmarks suggest, especially at this price. Obviously, it's mainly meant to be used for office work and not so much to edit videos or so. By the way, multitasking feels much smoother than on similar Windows devices. I guess that's due to the 8GB of RAM and the SSD. As I said, the Teclast F5 is fast enough for office work mainly. I did write a lot of articles with this convertible and that includes this review. It certainly is great for that. Apps like Microsoft Word and Chrome run very smoothly even when using them at the same time, side by side. In theory, you can edit pictures using Photoshop on this 2-in-1. That works indeed, however, it is not perfect for that. If you're working with complex files, a lot of layers and effects, the performance is not good enough. But it's fine if you need to do simple things from time to time. That's kind of how I can describe the gaming performance too. Simple games like Asphalt 9 do run because they are meant for less powerful devices. I also tried Cuphead and it does work fine too. I noticed some minor lags only. You can totally forget Fortnite on here. This is not a gaming notebook at all. The battery life is very disappointing. In my battery test, the Teclast F5 got a result of just 5.5 hours. For this test, I'm always looping NHD video at medium brightness. Well, those 5.5 hours are very weak, and that is a theoretical runtime only. In real life, it won't last you longer than 2 to maximum 4 hours. Yes, even when you're very careful, it will never last you a whole working day with office work. That is very sad. Alright, that's my Teclast F5 review. Is it a good 2-in-1 convertible? In fact, I personally enjoy it quite a lot. I've had fun working with it, especially because it is so small and easy to carry. And I've been also able to type on the keyboard comfortably. However, I would not recommend using demanding apps on here. But it's great for simple tasks like office work, and yes, maybe to do some minor Photoshop in between. Considering its price, the screen performance and keyboard are very good. The design and speakers are good enough too. Sadly, the battery life is really disappointing. As I said, I like the Teclast F5 a lot because it is so small and easy to handle. However, even with very simple office work, it will just never last you a whole working day. So if you need to work longer than a couple of hours a day, you need to bring a charger. That's unfortunate. I can recommend it if you're looking for an 11.6 inch convertible for office work, especially if you don't want to spend more than $300. But as I said, you really have to keep in mind that the battery life is not great. Let's take a look at a couple of alternatives. A direct competitor is made by the same manufacturer and is called Teclast F6 Pro. While it is a bit pricier, it also features a bigger 13.3 inch screen and a noticeably faster Intel Core M3 processor. So if you need more performance, this one you could check out. Another competitor is the Lenovo IdeaPad D330. If you want to have similar specs, you have to pay a bit more. However, it does have a much longer battery life. It is a 10 inch Windows tablet with a solid keyboard dock. Alright, that's my Teclast F5 review. If you have any questions, please feel free to write down below and check out mynexttablet.com. Under the best sections, you can always find my current recommendations. And I'm Andrzej for mynexttablet.com. Thanks for watching.